Hello, it's me, the Gingerman, and for yous that have been watching me for the last couple of years will know that I have almost, and I say almost, completed the entirety of Fife. Just a couple of more places left to visit. And beyond that, I do plan to leave Fife more regularly, head over the bridge, Linlithgow, Bowness, Falkirk, that area is on the Ginger radar. But right now, I have something else on my mind. As I was looking back on some old episodes, I thought, there's parts of Fife that I really didn't capture or do justice how I really want to capture them. So, beginning that journey of going back the way to go forward, I'm here in the beautiful village of Kelty. Show me what you got! Peace. Look at this. This is Kelty really showing off its mining heritage. As we come right into Kelty. We come into Kelty from the Cowden Beef Road. Some people might know it from the motorway, which is up that way. I'm just pointing in directions. Motorway's that way. There's Binarty Hill. There's Cowden Beef. Motorway, and the direction I'm heading in will be towards the motorway, towards Kelty. But anyway, I digress. Here is a wheel. The Lindsay Colliery, where on the 14th of December 1957, 9 men lost their lives in an underground explosion. And that's the thing with the mining industry, it took so many lives. But it's great that we've got so many monuments around Fife to remember and to remind us by. Because energy and just things working in society are something I feel that us modern people take for granted. Oh look, look at this, keep pumping, it's one of these.
Welcome to the Lindsay Colliery Memorial Garden. Records reveal that coal has been worked around the Kelty area since 1572. In the early years at Kelty, coals were worked by individuals under lease or by landowners such as the Adam family on Blairadam lands and the Earl of Moray on the Barony of Beath. The rapid growth of the Industrial Revolution in the 19th century, however, created a massive demand for fuel to power the factories and furnaces of British industry, and to drive the powerful steam engines of trains and ships that carried goods and raw materials around the country and around the world. In 1872, the Fife Coal Company was formed and began the expansion of the coal operations in the area. Shafts were sunk to exploit the deeper coal reserves in the Cowden Beath Lochore Basin to the east of the Great North Road. These deep pits would prove to be the jewels in the crown of the Fife Coal Company and sustain the economy of Kelty and the surrounding district for over 90 years. The Lindsay Colliery was named after Mr. William Lindsay, the first chairman of the Fife Coal Company, and the sinking of the first shaft began in 1873. Look southeast towards Cowden Beath and you will see A. and J. Nelson's haulage yard. The long building in the yard is the old pithead baths, canteen and medical centre. Miners entered clean at the Kelty end of the building and exited in their pit clothes at the Cowden Beath end. They then crossed the Great North Road and climbed steps to get to the screening plant, steelhead and winder, and the pit workshops. In addition to the vertical shafts, there were two surface mines. Coal was raised through the shaft and the surface mines were used for man riding and ventilation. Production waste was carried away in buckets on an aerial ropeway that ran eastwards across the road to the bings. The underground workings of the Lindsay were connected to nearby collieries, including the Aitken at the northeast end of Kelty, and in 1909 electric power was supplied to the Lindsay from the Aitken. Over the years that the Lindsay was working, there were many reports of accidents and deaths both above and below ground, but the single greatest loss of life was caused by an underground explosion on Saturday the 14th of December 1957 that caused the deaths of 9 miners and injured 11 more. We remember Daniel Anderson, Robert Cook. John Hughes, Thomas Johnson, William Masterton, William McCulloch, Hugh McPherson, Bernard Petrick, David Scott. This memorial garden was created by the Lindsay Disaster Memorial Fund Committee to honour the men who died and to mark the mining heritage of the village. A driving force in the committee was their secretary, Archie Campbell.
That took a lot of pumping, but it was worth it because I noticed on the plaque it said Doogery Scott. I think he's still going there because I pumped hard. I've been in Kelty 5 minutes and I've pumped Doogery Scott. But the information there, squeaky, the information there was fantastic. And you know what? I know so much more already about the importance of the mining industry on Kelty. Like, not just Kelty, but the whole surrounding area. It's just pure mining, and Kelty is right in the heart of it. And that is a beautiful touch there, that memorial. 10 out of 10. I'm getting Doogery Scott involved. Nice touch. Look at this. The Scottish Coal Race, Kelty, 27th of August. Two things here, right? 27th of August, well, that's the day after my birthday. So that's cool. If it matters to anyone other than me. But more importantly, look at this. A coal race. So I've never seen the coal race, but I've heard about it. And there's a race where people run with a bag of coal on their back. Now that, if ever there was dedication and a sort of significant monument to the coal industry, nothing defines it better than a coal race. That motorway, 1 mile. Told you the motorway was up this way, but also Salin and Dollar. Salin, not Saline. Kelty's like half a mile this way, but the sign for Kelty's half a mile that way. I don't know. Are we in no man's land here? Is this even Kelty? So I'm heading up that way to the football stadium, and we'll find out what's been going on at Kelty Hearts. Or at least a brief run around, because they are climbing the leagues in Scottish football. However, they currently lie bottom of the League One in Scotland. Dunfermline are top of League One in Scotland, but only 3 games in. Look at this is nice. Looking over the bowling green. In memory of all those who have died in service of their country. This is a lovely touch and a lovely memorial. In one instance, you can respect our fallen war heroes whilst in the same breath and the same look. You can take in Kelty Bowling Club at the same time. We've really looked after that green. Look at this. It's as good a green you're going to see. The KBC. That's quite an intimidating entrance. The away team must be intimidated walking through that entrance to the KBC. Nice church on the corner. The Kelty Turkish Barbers, the Crown Suite, and of course I've decided to come to Kelty at the busiest time of the day. Here it is. Welcome to Kelty. What are we looking for? Kelty Hearts FC right there. Where am I? I'm here. Right, so I've not got far to go. Up this way, turn right. I can do that. An apple a day keeps a doctor away. It's only the Kelty Health Centre. Nice. I love the amount of effort that's gone into painting things around Kelty. It's a touch of class. Anyway, right, we're going this way down towards the football stadium. We're going to check out Kelty Hearts ground. You know, maybe we might see Joe Cardle there doing some keepy uppies. I don't know. Get an autograph. I mean, I'll give Joe Cardle my autograph. This is like a haunted mansion. The haunted mansion of Kelty. I apologise if this is your house. Your house isn't a haunted mansion, it's just a house. Anyway, if think we're here. We're at New Central Park. And it has changed over the years. Look at the quality of the grass around here. You can't see it through the camera. Well, you can see it, you can't feel it through the camera. Kelty Hearts are looking after the local grass. That's what I'm going to say. Look at this. We've just had a lovely summer of sunshine and a good sprinkling of rain the last couple of days. And look at that. That is as green as it gets. Just ignore these wee sections. Anyway, the gates are open. I wonder if I could just saunter on in. My only criticism is I think they need to get their flagpole higher. I know, their status is rising, so should their flagpole. You can buy a brick. There's plenty of bricks left to go. Plenty of space. I'm just putting out there, the Kelty players have no excuses now. They've literally just got an outside jump. What? Bye Kelty Hearts. And hello, Woodland Walks to unknown pastures. Yeah, I'm just making it up. My plan of route so far was to head to Kelty Hearts Stadium. Now I'm going to worm my way up to Blairadam Forrest, because this is as big a part as Kelty as anywhere. And you'd be surprised how many people don't know where it is or what it is. And people are always asking me, Gingerman, where can I go for a walk? And I say, have you been to Blairadam Forrest? And they're like, no, don't know where that is. It's in Kelty, mate. It's in Kelty. This looks like New Kelty. You see that there? A bit of water, if you can see it through the camera. You probably can't, but that's Loch Oar. Look at that shot of Benarty Hill. Oh, you got Loch views, you got Benarty Hill views. Look at this, they've just thrown it together. Just thought, just stick it there, mate. Just stick it right there. I know where I'm at. I'm at opposite the entrance to Loch Oar Meadows. We're not going to Loch Oar Meadows, so I'm going to swing back down that way through what I believe to be Kelty Hill, and then we'll come back up towards Blairadam Forrest. And if I remember what Dougherty Scott said, the Adams family, it was owned by the Adams family. There we go. I was trying to think of something witty, some sort of witty joke about the Adams family there. Nothing came. So if you're watching this and you've got some great off-the-cusp humour on that, please let me know. Insert in the comments now. Actually, that's a call-out to Wildcat666, who just comments on YouTube on a Saturday night, and I love the guy's comments. What a guy, he's hilarious. And he's possibly my number one favourite person to comment anytime, because he's got the hottest takes on my episodes and they're funny. I like it. And he really likes Callum. So, and he's always asking for Callum. And I can't always give you Callum because Callum's a busy man, it would appear, and he's not always available. But I'm trying my hardest to get him out. He was going to maybe come out today, but he's away. He's away to a special event. Right, confirmed. There's the entrance to Loch Oar Meadows. So, I mean, I didn't intend to come this way, but this is the way we're going now. We're going back through Kelty Hill. And I only know this because of the Fife Pilgrims Way. There we go. For old time's sake, tag. That's the old Pilgrim Way knowledge. Hold on a second, I walked the Pilgrim's Way and missed this totem pole. No way. How did I miss it? How could I miss this giant shaft in the sky? So this is what we call a reverse Pilgrim's Way manoeuvre. Basically all I'm doing is I'm just going in the opposite direction I went on the Pilgrim's Way to help me locate something that I need to get located. That's it. Is that harvest time? don't know where I am. Now, this is the point where I'm going to go to the shop and then I'm going to get off the Pilgrim's Way and I'm going to head up this way. Yes, this way. A different direction. I have my snacks. Now I'm heading back in towards Kelty Village to then go to Blairadam Forrest. There's another sign for the cool race over there. Just a nice wee quiet. It looks like a nice memorial garden. Yes, Kelty Masonic Lodge. They're repping. Looks like it's still in use. 4th of August 1898. There you go. That's cool. Again, Kelty using colour to good effect on Kelty Hill Road. Now I've got some barbecue. Oops. I'm walking up towards what the locals call the Tin Bridge, which then is the connection from Kelty into Blairadam Woods or Forest. And it crosses over the, I'm going to say the M90 going north, the big motorway road. It's my favourite street name in Kelty. It's Croft Angry Road. We're going this way. So we're sweeping off Kelty Hill Road and we're heading up this way. There's a nice big park here as well that if you don't take the time to come into Kelty, you won't know it's here. I just got confirmed there, it's the M90 footbridge, so I was right. The M90 footbridge. Tin Bridge sounds nicer. Here's the skate park. Another big grass park. We've got a skate park. Just a big park. It looks like it's got a flying fox. It's got all the classics. Good work, Kelty. Here we go. Finally made it to the Tin Bridge. You. You've probably driven past this 100 times and never crossed it because it is the main motorway north. So you've got Perth, Dundee, all of those places. You've got to come through this way if you're going from north to south. There you go. I cannot tell you how cool that shade is. Oh, it's glorious. I love trees. I can go into the deep dark woods where it's extra cold, or I could just continue on, or this bit looks quite sunny. A, B or C? Choose now. Okay, if you're still watching, you chose option B, which is the straight on route. In the space of crossing a tin bridge, it's like I'm in a completely different world right now. You know, this is my most comfortable zone, as you could probably tell by watching my videos. Just being out by nature, peace, quiet, serenity, calmness, stillness. But I'm not afraid of busy places and lots of people. I like it, enjoy human interaction too, but you know, this is my inner happiness, this. Listen to that. Any fear of a drought has been dampened in the last couple of days. Cheers. An autopilot. That was fun, and I'd love to spend more time in the woods, but sadly, I'm about double the size of Kelty, as you've seen on the drone footage. So I'm going to head up this way and back into Kelty, and we'll conclude today's episode. It's got his wee sun cap on. Hello, horsey. Or is that a midgie mask? Is that a midgie mask? It's a horse midgie mask. I love it. I'd come and say hi, but there's loads of jaggies in the way between us. Right, I'm nearly at the exit slash entrance to Blairadam, where I'm going to bank left and head back into Kelty. That's where we're at right now. Is that some sort of Pictish stone up ahead? Oh no, it's just a stone that's got W written on it, not Pictish. It looked Pictish from a distance. Up close, not Pictish. Up close, not Pictish. You wanna see? Scotland's premier summer houses. They're like mini crisp, They're like mini crystal domes. Or Christmas baubles. New life human-sized Christmas baubles. Oh, look at this view as you walk down into Kelty. This is why I came this way. 10 out of 10. Sleeping giant. Lock ore. Hello, Fife. On our doorstep. Look at this. Look at this. Just walking down here and seeing all this just in front of me like this. I've driven down here. You know something? I've never walked it. And there's nothing. There's nothing more life. I'm going to wait for the cars to pass. But there's nothing more life-affirming than grand nature. Because this is it. This is literally life. Right in front of you. I'm not gonna lie, this is slightly more terrifying than the Tin Bridge. The Tin Bridge has a sort of defend barrier, whereas this has just got this. So right next to each other we have the beauty of a forest right next to the very useful but very human and almost destructive motorway. It's noisy in it. It's not as peaceful and serene as the forest.
Welcome to Kelty, home of the Kelty Colliery. It's 27th of August.
More information, it's the 23rd. Coal race at 12 p.m. Will I be there? FYI, if you're on the Kelty Council, great work on the signs, but you've got a lot of welcome to Kelty signs in Kelty. But at least you always know where you are. Saying that, there are about 10 different ways into Kelty, so, you know, probably need all the signs. Anyway, what a day I've had here in Kelty. First of all, I pumped a Doogery Scott. I got filled with knowledge about Kelty and its mining history. I went to Kelty Hearts. I crossed the Tin Bridge. I flew over Blairadam Forrest. And, you know, I had a really life-affirming moment walking into Kelty. So, Kelty, I'm sure I'll be back, if not for one of the coal races, or to watch Kelty Hearts parading down the high street with the Scottish Cup. Either or, I'll be back. Thanks for having me, Kelty. Peace! I think Kelty Hearts are going to beat Dunfermline 2-1.